Good afternoon, beloved of the Lord. It is a wonderful afternoon. Once again, Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is coming soon. As the events are taking place, time is running out. We must quicken the footsteps. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we just pray before I get into the revelation so that the world knows what is happening. Hallelujah. Shall we just pray? My dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you for your glory. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your anointing in this place. Let your presence, let your glory, Lord, as I stand before this altar of Ebenezer, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I render every power of the enemy useless and powerless, Lord. Every demonic screen monitoring me, Lord, I release the fire to consume them now. I bind every demons, Lord, monitoring me now. I render them useless and powerless, Lord. Influence me, guide me, Holy Spirit, as I release this message, Lord. It's not by might, nor by power, but it's only by your spirit that you watch over your word to perform it, mighty God. For this is an urgent message to your people, Lord, so that the body of Christ may stand, Lord, with us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master. In Jesus Christ's name I pray, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Beloved of the Lord, thank you so much. This is a very urgent message. Yesterday, the 27th, there was a summit in South Africa, the BRICS summit, which started on the 25th and it ended yesterday on the 27th. The BRICS summit consists of Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. So the one that was hosting this 10th BRICS summit was South Africa. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And the head of the summit is Ramaphosa, the president of South Africa, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lo and behold, this also is not shocking that the blood moon also started on the 27th, the same day when the summit started, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. This is to awaken the church so that the church wakes up and be on fire for Jesus Christ, because now they are intensifying. Now they are coming to Africa. They are trying to recruit as many nations so that they form an army. The Ottoman Empire, Erdogan, Turkey was also in the same BRICS summit. China, that's a dragon. Russia, that's the other beast that will rise in the book of Ezekiel chapter 38 and 39. Now listen to what happened. The blood moon started on the 27th. It crossed over, it's crossing even up to today. Now, what's surprising and what's confirmation and confirming now that he's come to visit my nation where the end time prophet is, which is I, on the 28th of July, 2018. Today, Erdogan has visited our nation. Right now, as I speak, he's in our nation. I went to warn the government. On the 28th, on the 25th, I went to warn the religious affairs minister to go and warn the president that they should not allow Erdogan in this nation because he's the Antichrist that will form the Ottoman Empire, that will gather many Islamic and many nations, many religious nations trying to form one new world order in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, to come and try to arise against the Christians, to persecute the Christians, to wipe away Christianity. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Not only that, to come against Israel, the nation of God. Because Zambia has a mandate, like I always keep on telling you. Now you will believe today that I'm the end time prophet that God has called for this purpose, for this mission, that I'm the end time Zerubbabel. Now I cannot just sit and see Satan come to bring his demonic altar in our nation. Because we have a godly altar in the nation of Zambia. Now the devil reigns in Turkey. As you go to Revelation chapter 2, verse 8 to 18, you find the Pergamum and Thyatira. That's where Satan dwells, Turkey. And that's where the Antichrist, the beast himself. Russia will form alliances with Turkey and Iran. They will form an alliance and they will try to come against Israel. Remember, Iran is the former Persia in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, where Haman was the one that was trying to persecute the Jews. Now they are forming an army. They're forming alliances. China is also forming alliances. Germany is also forming alliances. The church needs to wake up and start fasting and praying and to be on fire, because the devil has already started moving on rampage. Yesterday, I sent a message on On WhatsApp, in fact, 2 days ago, I sent a message on WhatsApp warning everyone, in fact, warning the president of Zambia in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But I do not know. I think the message was not delivered. The devil tried, obviously, to block this message. But because now I'm online, I'm on YouTube today in the mighty name of Jesus for this as an urgent message. I urge all prophets, all apostles to stand for the nation of Zambia, that Satan will not rule, will not partner with this nation, Zambia, because of the altar and because of the covenant that we have with God and because of the purpose and the mandate that we have for the nation of Zambia in Israel, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now I call upon the pastors, the apostles, the prophets, the apostles, the Christians, the body of Christ to arise and pray for the nation of Zambia. Stand in the gap right now in the name of Jesus Christ as I speak. The Erdogan has entered the nation with his financial accountant, the one to use finances to try to entice the president of Zambia. Already I want the government, but he said they do not listen. Just as Jeremiah and the other prophets used to warn the kings. They warned them, but they did not listen. But I warned them, they did not listen. So I pray and I urge you, warriors in Christ, stand in the gap for the nation of Zambia. Stand in the gap because of the purpose that God has for this nation. Once you stand for the nation of Zambia, God will richly reward you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We'll soon meet in Israel. I'll be there in Israel very, very soon in the mighty name of Jesus to accomplish God's purpose. On the 26th of July, 2018, that was the day before yesterday, Jesus Christ visited me on the altar. I was praying on my altar. My altar is called Ebenezer. I call it Ebenezer because it's called the Stone of Help, and thus the Lord has brought us this far because the Lord told me to name my altar Ebenezer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As I was praying, Jesus Christ told me to look at him. So I looked at him as he visited me on the altar. He was on the left-hand side. He said, bring your finger. So I gave him my right finger. Then he put the signet ring to confirm and to fulfill the purpose of Zerubbabel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, which is found in Zechariah chapter 4. If you read Zechariah chapter 4, you will read about Zerubbabel. Not only am I the end time Elijah, I'm also Zerubbabel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. This is getting intense in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As the Lord spoke to me and reminded me, Yellowstone volcano will take away many lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Japan earthquake. Earthquake and the storms are coming. Tsunami, typhoon are coming and kill a lot of lives in Japan. In the mighty name, Italy earthquake is very imminent. It will take place soon, just very, very soon. It's very imminent. Cambodia earthquake is taking place very, very soon. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, the God that answereth by fire, the God that never slumbers nor sleeps, Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus Christ is Lord. And that's why now the time for the end time army to arise. Yesterday, not only did the Lord Jesus Christ give me a signet ring, yesterday he gave me a torch, like at the Olympics, there's that torch that the runner that goes ahead of the people carries, that same torch. He gave me a banner, a torch, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, signifying now that the time has come for me to move nation to nation, college to college, university to university. So I pray the prophets that are genuine prophets to continue to stand for me in the gap. Those that God has assigned for this mission to stand for the end time prophet, the end time Elijah with the spirit of Elijah and Moses in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, arise. Because on the 25th, in fact, the same day when the summit started in the BRICS, John the Baptist appeared to me. So when he appeared to me, he said, son, come, I want to show you something. And when I came out of my spirit, he showed me Vatican City, the Vatican City that is in Italy. Then he showed me the Pope and the priests worshiping the devil seated on the throne in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Lo and behold, beloved of the Lord, know that the throne of Vatican, that's where the mother of harlots is in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the, that's a false prophet, the false prophet. Pope Francis is a false prophet in the end times. We are very left. Remember what the Bible says, that those that know their God, according to Daniel 11, verse 32, shall stand strong and do exploits in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Arise, arise, O believers of the Lord. Arise, O Christians. Arise, O body of Christ, the apostles, the prophets. Arise now, the army to arise, to move as Satan has started moving on rampage, because they know that the time is up. The devil knows that the time is short in the mighty name of Jesus. The World War III is very imminent in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I will not continue warning about this now. Arise, beloved of the Lord. Arise, the body of Christ. The end time army now is being formed. Very soon, very soon. The Lord told me in 7 weeks, he will move me to Israel. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. The God that answereth by fire. The God that never slumbers. Now you know the reason why Erdogan has entered the nation of Zambia. Why Satan now, the altar of Satan, has come with his altar to enter the nation of Zambia, which has a godly altar in the mighty name of Jesus, because of the covenant that we have with God. We actually declared Zambia as a Christian nation on the 29th of December, 1991. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. We put it into declaration in our constitution in 1996. In the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Now it seems the excellency, the president of the nation of my country, does not understand the spiritual things. Now that he will know that it's God who is doing his work right now. So as many believe and stand in the gap, that two or more were that they're gathered in the name of Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ answers prayers. So I urge you, body of Christ, arise and stand for the nation of Zambia. Arise and stand for the nation of Zambia in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Then the Lord Jesus Christ spoke to me today and reminded me the wildfires are going upon the Asia, Europe, North America, South America. The wildfires are going around even parts of Africa, even plagues that are going coast to coast and all around the world in the mighty name of Jesus, because of the end times that we are living in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Thank you, beloved of the Lord, for hearing this message. Please pass it on to other believers, to other prophets, so that they know the times that we're living in. The blood moon now is a sign that Erdogan has entered the nation of Zambia to confirm my calling as an end time prophet and as an end time Elijah. Today, on the 28th of July 2018, mark this day in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It was the 28th of June 2018 when I came on the scene on YouTube and introduced myself as the end time Elijah. Now today is the 28th of July, exactly 1 month in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God works in numbers. He never lies. He watches over his word to perform it. As he promised me on oath, that through me, many souls will be saved, that he will use me to bring sanity in the body of Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is a privilege and honor, because I'm not ashamed of the gospel. According to Romans 1:16, for it is the power of God unto salvation, first to the Jew, then to the Gentile, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that the message of the cross is foolishness to those that are perishing, but to those that have been saved, it is the power of God and to salvation, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, the God that answereth by fire, that since the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffereth violence, and only the violent ones shall take it by force, according to Matthew 11, verse 12. Now time to arise, body of Christ, believers in Christ, arise, fast and pray, dwell in the word, pray, let us pray, continue to pray for one another in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Shall we just pray in the name of Jesus as I close in Jesus Christ's name, hallelujah. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for your message that has been released. Now the body of Christ will arise in your fire, in your power, in your anointing to pray for the nation of Zambia, to pray for one another, to pray for all the saints around the world. Mighty God, for strengthening, because the devil now has gone on rampage, because he knows that his time is short. In Jesus' name I pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master. In the name of Jesus Christ, if you've never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, please repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you as a sinner. I accept that you died on the cross and 3 days again, you rose again from the dead. I know, Lord Jesus Christ, that you are coming soon. I've seen now that the devil is a liar. I denounce and renounce him in my life. Be the Lord of my life. I open my heart to you as your word declares in John 1, verse 12, that to those that believed in you, to those that received you, you gave them the right to become children of God. Lord, I ask for your rights, mighty God. Give me the right to be your son, to be your daughter in the mighty name of Jesus. I open my heart to you. Come and live in my heart in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I prayed, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.